Hello friends, welcome to this video. In this video we will learn how to extract bounding box from a binary segmentation mask. To learn more about it, make sure that you watch the complete video and subscribe the channel. So without any further delay, let's start the video. Here we are in our item text editor. Now first of all we'll take a look at the dataset first. So dataset basically contains 17 images and their binary mask, and these images are from the KVCR dataset. To download the complete dataset, please check the description for the link. So here are the 17 images, and these are basically polyp segmentation images. So here in these images we have to find the polyps and their respective binary masks are there. So these masks, for these masks we are going to extract the bounding boxes. Now I'll show you how the output of this code will look. So you can see on the left hand side we have this RGB image with a bounding box in blue color, and this rectangle or the square box can be drawn if we have these coordinate, that x1 y1 and this x2 y2. Okay, so we're going to extract these x and y coordinate from this mask. Okay, so this is how it would look at the end of this program. So let's start the code. Now I'll remove all these images and we'll start writing the code. Okay, so first of all we are going to import all the required libraries. Okay, so here we have imported the OS library, the NumPy, basically the NumPy array, then CV2 to read and resize and write the image back, then glob to extract the images and mask, TQDM, basically a progress bar. And the last one is really important, that is label, region props and find contour functions. So these are basically going to used for extracting bounding boxes from those masks. Okay. So first of all we are going to create a function which is used to create a directory, because we need to save the mask in this results folder. Now I will remove this results folder here. Okay, and it would be created automatically. Take the path. First of all we are going to check if that path exists or no. So if this path does not exist, then create that path. It's my mistake. Okay, so now if this path, this given path does not exist, then it would automatically create that path. Okay, now we'll go to our main function. First of all, we are going to load the data set. We have images and their mask. So we're going to say globe. And inside globe, we're going to give the path and data set. Basically, a pattern. First is the data. And inside data, we have folder called image. And inside images, we have 17 images. Okay. So after image we're going to write star. We want to extract all the images, and same we're going to do for the mask. Instead of image we're going to write mask here. It's basically going to remain the same. And next we're going to sort the data using the sorted function, because we want the same sequence of data in both image and mask, as their names are same. Now we're going to create a folder to save images. Okay, spelling mistakes are there. Again, spelling mistake. Okay, we're gonna say create dir, the function which we have created, and we're gonna say results. Now we are going to loop over the data set. Okay, and here on the looping we are going to use the TQDM, basically a progress bar, which usually indicates how many iterations are done. Okay, so we're going to say for x comma y, so x and y represents the image and mask path in TQDM, and inside TQDM again a mistake, we're going to use zip function, because we have two lists, images and masks.
Next, we're gonna have a variable called total, where we're gonna give the length of images, basically the number of iterations which need to be done. Okay. So first of all, we need to extract the name. Basically, x and y are path, and after all the process complete, we're gonna save the images. If you remember that result folder, it contains images, and we need a name to save those images. So first of all, I'm gonna print the x and y variable. I'm gonna break it here. And where is the terminal? Okay, here is the terminal, and we're gonna say mask to bbox. Okay. Oh yeah. I knew, but the error is okay. This is the problem. Directly copied it. See, this is the image path, and this is the mask path, and both the images are mask are in JPG format. So we need to extract this name. Okay. So first of all, we gotta split it. I'm gonna say name equals to x dot split, and because we are going to split it on the base of this slash, and we're going to print the name. Here you're going to see we have a list of elements. First is data, then image, and then name with the extension. So we need this last element. Okay, you can say minus one. So now we have successfully extracted the image with the name. If you want this extension, it's okay, it's not an issue. But let's say you want only name of the image, you don't want extension, then again you can split it. The base of it is a dot. You will see now we have two elements. First is a name and then an extension. Now on the zeroth index, we have the name. So you see we have successfully extracted the name from this entire path. So now this part is complete. We have extracted the name. So we're gonna see, write a comment here. Extracting the name. Okay. So do make a habit of writing proper comments in the code. It's easy for the new person to see your code and easily know what you're doing. Next, we're gonna read the image and mask. We're gonna say x equals to cv2 I am read. X, we are going to read it as an RGB image. By the way, image don't have any specific role here. We need mask, but to plot that these coordinate on the image, we need this RGB image. Now we are going to read the mask in a grayscale format. Okay, so we have the mask. Now is the main time to detect bounding box. Detecting bounding boxes. Okay, so let's create a function called. Okay, so before that we need one function. Okay, so now we have mask. If you remember, these are grayscale mask, and these are basically black and white images. So it has only 2 pixels, 0 and 255. So before that, we're going to create a function called mask to border. So this function takes the mask and give us a black and white image with only mask, not the mask, the boundaries of the mask. Okay, so let's start working on this function first, because we need it for detecting the bounding boxes. So first of all, we are going to create a blank image, a black image, okay, with the same dimension as the original mask. So we're gonna say border equals to np dot zeros with a height and width. Okay, now we're gonna use this find contour function to detect contours. Okay, so we have this function find contours, and we're gonna give mask here and a threshold value. We're gonna give it 128. Okay, because we have black and white image, so 120 is really perfect here. Next, we're gonna loop over these contours. NT. Okay, it's spelling mistake. Now within this contour we have some indexes. Okay, some integer variable. x equals to integer t0, y equals to integer t1. Okay, now we're going to say border x and y should be 255. Okay, these are basically pixel values, pixel coordinates, where we need to have white colors. So basically we are building a border here, and now we're going to say return border. Okay, so first of all I'm going to show you how this function works. Border equals to mask to border, and you take mask. Okay, now let's save the image here. This is basically border image here. So we're gonna say cv2.imwrite results, and then we have our name with the extension, and here we're gonna say border. Okay, so now we're gonna run this program. Okay, so mask is not, yeah, it's correct, mask is not defined, it's y, it's not mask, the variable y contain the mask. Okay, it's, yeah, we have used this big, it would onward run for one iteration only. Okay, if you see, we have this border image, only contain the border. Now we're going to use this border image to detect the bounding boxes using the other two functions which we imported. Okay, so now we can clearly see, let's run this for more than one image, and we can see it for other mask also. You can see we have 17 masks, and all of them are processed really fast. You can see these are really high dimensional images. You can see this is really high image. It's not about you need to have a fixed size image. It can be any size image. This program would work on any size image. Thing is that you need to have these proper shapes. Like here we have some mismatch, it's not connecting, so here we can have some problem while detecting bounding boxes. But figure like these, which are complete, okay, they are really easy to work with. Okay, so you need to make sure that these border images are really good. Okay, because basically it's going to detect these connected figures. Okay, it does not know anything about the mask, it just detect the complete figure and give its bounding boxes or the coordinate points. Okay, now we work on another function called mask to bbox. So bbox basically mean bounding boxes. So first of all, we're going to create a variable, a list called bboxes. First is this function border, and here we're going to call a function called mask to bbox, and we're going to give it the mask. So we have this border from this mask variable. Then we're going to use this label function. Then call it lbl label, and this label takes this border image, and for next we're going to detect the props in this. So we're going to have use this region props function, and we're going to give it this label output. Now within props we have basically a list, so we're going to say for prop in props, and this prop basically contain the bounding box coordinates. So it's like x1 equals to prop dot bbox 1. Then we have y1, it's at the 0th index, like this. We have x2 and y2. X1 and y1 are basically x min and y min. Okay, and x2 and y2 are basically x max and y max. Okay, here the indexes would change to 3 and 2. So now we have these x1, x2, y1, y2. Now we're going to append them in our bounding box variable. Okay, so it should be by 2. Next, we're going to return these. Okay, so it's going to give us this big box. Okay, now we need to mark these bounding boxes on the image. So we're going to say marking big boxes on the image. We're going to say for big box in big boxes. So here we're going to use a function from OpenCV called cv2.rectangle. Okay, it first take the input image, which is x, then it take the bounding box point. So it first it take x1 and y1, and if you remember, it's the index 0 contain x1 and here index 0, index 2 contain y1, and like this it next it gonna take x2 and y2. Okay, so now coordinates are complete. Next, we need to give a color to the rectangle which we are drawing on the figure. So it basically take the format of this color is BGR, not RGB. So let's draw a blue rectangle, 255, 0 and then 0. So we have pixel 255 for the blue and green and red, we have 0. Next is the thickness of this bounding box. Let's say 2 first, and then we can change it accordingly. Now we want to save this x image here. We are going to run it and check for it. So no error is there. Okay, now you can see here on this original image. Okay, if you see the size, this is original image. Every image is original size. We haven't resized the image. If you see, we just read the image. We haven't resized any image here. If you see here, bounding box is detected. You can see it's really large image. So it work on any image size. Okay, you can see here also we have one polyp. Here you can see we have two polyps, so it is successfully detected two polyps also. But if you enlarge and see this, we have extra, I think this is an extra bounding box here. So sometimes it's problematic, like regions where the border image is not complete, you have to work on that part also. It's basically not a complete or a perfect work, it's basically an improved work. It need to be improved upon. So I hope if you find an issue, you will be able to solve it yourself, or you can comment below. We can together improve it. Okay, you can see it's able to detect even the smallest possible polyps also. Now let's attach some mask also in front of this labeled image. Mask is in Y and X image is in 3 channel format and mask is in 1 channel. So let's create a function. Okay, parse mask. The mask is of shape, let's say height by width. Okay, now we're going to expand the dimension of the mask. On the last axis, so we're going to say -1. Next, mask equals to np.concatenate. Mask, and then mask. So we're going to concatenate these images on the last axis. So it would form, the mask size would be height width by 3. Then we're going to return this mask. Okay, so now we're going to say cat images, basically concatenate images. You have to take two images. First is x, second is this mask, which passes through this mask parse mask function, that is y, and we're going to concatenate on the axis 1. So we have this cat images. Okay, now we're going to run this program again, and this time you're going to see the bounding box image and the mask also. I can clearly see where the mask is and where the bounding box is. Okay, you can see it's absolutely correct. Okay, it's successfully detecting the bounding boxes from these binary masks. So I hope now it's clear to you how you're going to convert a binary mask to a bounding box. Okay. it would not be perfect. I'm seeing you again. It would have some issue. It would have some problem. So please do comment out those problem, okay, or message them to me. I'll try to solve them. Or if you find any problem and you solve it, so do comment it out or give me some information about it, so I can also update the code accordingly. Okay, you can see we have successfully detected these two mask also as separate polyps, and we have two coordinate point with it. If you see, I've just seen this thing now in the little corner. If you see, there's a blue bounding box here. It's also detecting this. So one thing which we can do here is that we can check the area. Like we have coordinate, we can calculate the height and width. So we can say if like this blue bounding box is really small, which is in the corner, so we can ignore them. So I hope you can write that code easily. Okay, it's not a issue with you. So I hope with this video I was able to give you some new information. If I did, then please click that like button and subscribe the channel also. And do check out my other videos, which are on the UNet, REST UNet, Deep Lab. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.